Welcome to the video news of the week. It appears that, as it marks its 35th year, the Dixville Races has reached the finish line. In an announcement this week, organizers Fran Bigney and Julie Riffon say that unless another group comes forward to take over, the races will no longer be held. Responsibility for pulling together the annual event, which features a half marathon, relay race, and fun walk, has rested with the two women for the past few years, and they say they can no longer organize this event alone. The races, which are run from Dixville to Colebrook during the peak of fall colors, last year saw a record 216 participants take part. The event raises money for a number of local organizations, as well as providing $500 scholarships to a graduating student in each of the area high schools. Julie Riffon said the decision did not come easy.
Well, both Fran and I feel very torn. This has been a labor of love for us. We are very hopeful that another organization or business will step up and want to partner with us as a transition year. If that does not happen this year, and someone in the race will not happen in the fall because we won't be doing it, and people feel badly about that and want to do it for 2012, I think we'd be more than glad to transition that year as well.
We also spoke with Fran Bigney, who told us about the work that goes into organizing the event.
It's an incredible amount of work. A lot of detail. Julie and I both are very fortunate in that we're both very good with detail. So together we're a good team. And all the volunteers that we have that we pull together on race day are very dependable and very capable. Julie said it's part of the culture, the fabric of the community. And she's right, it's 35 years. That's quite a lot of weaving. We had over 200 runners last year, which was the biggest that we've ever had. It's definitely a wonderful thing to do, and people get a lot of enjoyment out of it. And people get a lot of enjoyment out of this race. It is one of the prettiest races in the state. It's always at the height of foliage season. It's actually spit snow one time when I was running the race. And we've had people come up to us and say it's one of the most well-organized races that they've been to, which blows my mind, because it's right now it's just Julie and I, and I'm thinking, gee, you know, how can you do it? And folks ask me, how do you do it and run it? But if it weren't for all the amazing volunteers, the key clubs, all the sponsors, you know, like I said, all the finish line people, the registration people that pull it together at the end, I wouldn't be able to run it.
The Groveton Select Board held a public meeting this week to discuss the back taxes owed on the former Wausau paper mill and Groveton paperboard parcels. The selectmen discussed with the public the idea of settling the back taxes on four of the parcels and the town taking over ownership for those sites. Three are vacant lots and one is a former Groveton Paperboard office building on Main Street. If it's suitable, say the selectmen, it could be used as a permanent home for the town offices. They will be meeting with the town's building committee within a week to discuss whether or not to move forward with this idea. The Colebrook Elementary School parking lot was a scene yesterday of a mock disaster drill designed to show students the consequences of driving while intoxicated. Sponsored by SAD and called every 15 minutes, high school students watched as emergency personnel arrived in the scene of a simulated two-car accident with fatalities. In the simulation, the driver was arrested, and today the event continues with a mock trial. The project was organized by Chelsea Brooks, a member of the senior class, in conjunction with SAD. Meanwhile, on Monday evening, the Groveton Fire Department and Groveton Ambulance Corps took part in a training session at a building on Brooklyn Street.
A number of events took place at the Colebrook Elementary School Gymnasium last Saturday. The events included the Regional Science Fair, which brought together local students for special projects. Now in its second year, the students competed for trophies and medals while displaying their work on poster boards in the gymnasium.
My partner Chelsea Simpson and I went around and we asked 10 teachers and 10 students which they preferred, milk chocolate or dark chocolate. Once we did that, we waited a couple days and we went back and told them the health benefits of dark chocolate compared to milk, because milk has none, while dark chocolate actually lowers blood pressure and your cholesterol, and it's great for heart disease. So we told them that, and then we saw if they chose the dark chocolate over the milk chocolate, and it changed in like 30% of our people.
Must be a popular display with the chocolate samples there too.
We brought people in with our chocolate.
My exhibit I did Where's Waldo?
The winner of Most Scientific and Best Overall was Sarah Brewer of Stratford School with her Where's Waldo project.
I got first place in Most Scientific and first place in Best Overall.
The Colebrook Kiwanis held a child identity program in the gymnasium as well. In an attempt to combat information loss when children go missing, the ID kits being assembled in the gym would provide authorities with vital information in their search. We spoke with Coos County Sheriff Jerry Marcoux about the day's activities.
Today we're going to do a child ID program, which means we're going to do photographs, we're going to do DNA swabs, and we're going to do fingerprints. For some reason a child should come up missing. The parents would have this to fall back on if we needed it to give out to the media and for identification purposes later on. Put on by the Kiwanis in cooperation with the Colebrook Police Department and the Coos County Sheriff's Department. It's all been positive reactions, so we're very happy with the program.
Canaan School students took to the stage for a talent show on Friday evening. The music ranged from disco to Katy Perry.
Gavin made a verse and whoa, in it lived the country boy called Johnny B. Good, who never ever learned to read and write so well, but he could play guitar.
Hey Jude, don't be afraid, you were made to.
Also on Friday evening, more music was filling the air in the Colebrook Library's basement during the Great North Woods Committee for the Arts' first open mic of the season. Chronicle photographer Joy Huber took this stunning video of high water at the spillway by Murphy Dam in Pittsburgh last week. More rain is predicted for the weekend, as well as a little snow early on. Temps range from 51 to 38 on Friday and raise slightly to a high of 59 on Saturday. Sunday clears up with a high of 59 and a low of 43. Last Friday, the Groveton Eagles traveled to Pittsburgh for these softball and baseball matchups.
There you go. Go hard. Go hard.
Groveton teams won both of the games. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.